بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome back again to the school of Karbala. Today, Sister Fatima Al-Salami is our special guest. And inshallah, we'll be talking about what we learned from the school of Karbala. Assalamu alaikum, Sister Fatima.
Alaikum assalam.
So as you know, our broadcast is called the School of Karbala. If you don't mind me, I would like to ask you a very quick question.
Of course.
So the question is, can you tell us a little bit about Sayyida Ruqayya alayhi salam?
A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillahi ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Sayyida Ruqayya alayhi salam was a vivacious child full of love and happiness. Everyone loved Ruqayya alayhi salam. She was also a very religious girl. From the age of 2, she took great care to make sure that her head and face were properly covered as the pure dress of coat, wear hijab when in public. Ruqayya alayhi salam was Imam Hussein's most beloved child. Our third Imam alayhi salam used to pray for a daughter in his night prayer. And the birth of Ruqayya was often a result of those night prayers. Imam Hussein was often heard to say, "A house without Sakina would not be worth living in." She always had a sweet and cheerful smile and a very friendly nature. Other children thought her companion as much as the grown-ups did. She was very generous and always shared whatever she had with others. There was a special bond between Imam Abbas alayhi salam and Ruqayya alayhi salam. Imam Abbas loved her more than he did his own children. If Ruqayya requested for anything, Imam Abbas would not rest until he satisfied her request. There was nothing that Imam Abbas would not do to make Ruqayya alayhi salam happy. During the journey from Medina to Mecca and then Mecca to Karbala, Imam Abbas was often seen riding up to the mahmal, in which Ruqayya sat to make sure that she had everything she wanted in life. Ruqayya alayhi salam loved her uncle just as much. While in Medina, she would visit several times a day. The house in which Imam Abbas alayhi salam lived in with his mother, Sayyida al-Banin alayhi salam. Like any other 4 or 5 year old, when Ruqayya alayhi salam went to bed at night, she wanted to spend some time with her father. Imam Hussein would tell her stories about the Prophet alayhi salam and the battles fought by her grandfather, Imam Ali alayhi salam. She would rest her head on her father's chest, and Imam Hussein would not move from her until she fell asleep. When the second of Muharram, the armies of Yazid began to gather at Karbala, and Imam Hussein said to his sister, Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam, "The time has come for you to get Sakina used to going to sleep without me being there." Ruqayya alayhi salam would follow her father at night, and Imam Hussein alayhi salam had to gently take her to her aunt, Sayyida Zainab alayhi salam, or Sayyida Rabab, her mother. At Karbala, from the 7th of Muharram, access to water became blocked by the army of Yazid, and water became scarce. Ruqayya alayhi salam shared whatever little water she had with others. Ruqayya alayhi salam would first make sure that they had some before taking any herself. When Ruqayya alayhi salam saw Imam Hussein bringing the blood-drenched alam, she knew that her uncle Imam Abbas had been martyred. From that day on, Ruqayya alayhi salam never complained of thirst. Ruqayya never again asked anyone for water. Sayyida Zainab would persuade her to take a few sips, but she herself would never ask never ask for water or complain of thirst.
Ahsanti, Sister Fatima, that was very good. I ask Sayyida Ruqayya to bless you, inshallah. Assalamu ala al-Husayn, wa ala Ali ibn al-Husayn, wa ala awlad al-Husayn, wa ala ashab al-Husayn. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.